Hi, Javad is here. In this video, we are going to teach you how to create your topographies and topo-surfaces automatically by your surveyor point files. And it is really easy to do this, and you are not going to do them manually. In this video, I will show you the process clearly. For some times, when a surveyor pick up the points from the site in real cases, we have this kind of files. For example, it will gonna be in text file or CSV or Excel file. But for Revit, you need to export them as a CSV file. If, for example, if you have a text file, open it with your Excel software and go to the export part or save as part and click the place that you want to save it. And from here, choose CSV or in here, comma delimited, or CSV. This is the best format that you can work with in Revit. Okay, as you can see, I have the Excel file and also I have the CSV file for this one. And I will put about 15 other text file for you in my Patreon page. You can access it from there very easily. Okay, let's go to Revit, and in here, you need to be in 3D or any view you want. Then go to the Massing and Size tab, and from here click on Topo Surface. And in here we have an option which is Create from Import. Then you need to click on Specify by Point File. As you can see, it is telling us that you can work with text file and CSV. But text file doesn't work that well, so my suggestion is to use CSV file or comma delimited files instead of text files. Okay, click on a specify point file, and in here choose this one. And for the unit, it depends on your point file. In this file, the dimensions are according to meter, so I'm going to put it on meter. If the dimension of your file is about on millimeter or in inch, you can change it in here very easily, and you can check it with your surveyor too before creating the topo surface. Okay, click on OK. Let's go to 3D view. As you can see, we have our levels here, but because our topography is much bigger, it is the topography according to the point that we have. It's a slope that you can see here. The next step, you only need to click on finish, and you have the topography. Let me put it on the shaded mode, and let's bring it in some place reasonable. As you can see, my levels are not very in a good place, so we have two way, or we need to change our survey point and our project point places, or we need to change the topo surface location. It depends on you and depends on your purposes. Okay, let's bring it down. For example, let me bring it down in here. Something like this. I want to, let me make my levels bigger and let me put it on something like 120. And let's go to north, for example, and let's make them bigger. It is kind of a cut plane in here because we have a far clip, I think, or our elevation is in the topography. We need to check it. Let's go to the level one, or maybe site. And we need to move these elevations out of this place. Okay, let me put it on 150, 1500 to see these. You can see you need to be careful because sometimes it is going to drag with this. To prevent from this, you can see we have an option in here, drag elements and selection. Let me turn it off, and now it is much easier to work with these overlapping elements in here. Make sure to put them outside of this. Maybe let's put it on 1 to 1000, and that's great. And now you are good to go to create your building pad, to create your project. You need to adjust it in the west and east part too. I'm not going to tell any more explanation because other parts are really easy and you know it. I just wanted to show you the process that you can create automatically your surfaces with your surveyor Excel file or point file. I hope this video has been helpful for you. Please, if it was, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. I have another video that will show you how to create cut and fill calculation in Revit automatically. You can go there and check it too. I will see you on the next session.